Hello students, today in this class we will study the states of matter, solids, liquid and gas. We will study properties of liquids, okay, in this class. See, we have already understood what is matter, okay, then what properties of particles of matter, and in the last class we have studied about the properties of solids also. So in this class we will study the properties of liquids, okay. So states of matter is there, these are the three forms of matter, solid, liquid and gas. Mainly other two forms are there, one is plasma, another one is called as BEC, okay. That is not there for your syllabus, no need to worry about those, okay. So we already learned about solids, properties of solids in the last class, okay. So in this class we'll learn about the properties of liquids. So what are properties of liquids? In this class we'll learn properties of liquids as well as properties of gas also, okay. First we'll look at properties of liquids. So what are the properties of liquids? So first one, no fixed shape but fixed value. That means liquids does not have any fixed shape. It takes the shape of the container you are pouring it. For example, the water you are taking, does it have any shape? No, it does not have any shape. We cannot say water is having a rectangular shape or circular shape, nothing like that. If you put it in a rectangular container, it will take rectangular shape. If you put it in a circular container, it takes circular shape. If you put it on a triangular container, it takes triangle shape. So water takes the shape of the container on which it is put. So liquids are taking the shape of the container on which they are put, okay. So they are not having any particular shape, okay. They are not having any fixed shape, but they have fixed value. Liquids are having fixed value. For example, if you take in a glass, say in a glass if you take 100 ml of water, 100 ml of water if you take, okay, in a glass, and if you transfer this to another glass, the water will be same 100 ml, okay. If you transfer it to a circular container, okay, almost a circular container, if you transfer it to a circular container, still it will be 100 ml. Means water is having fixed value, it will not change its value. So it is fixed, it is having fixed value. Not only water, every liquids are having fixed value. So the first property of liquids, no fixed shape but fixed value they are having. Their liquids are having no fixed shape, but they are having fixed value. Second point, interparticle distance are larger. See here, the interparticle distance are larger compared to solids. Solids we have seen, we have continuously seen in the solids, last class we have seen, they are closely packed. The molecules are highly and closely packed in solids, okay. But in liquids they are little bit different. In liquids there is not too much closely packed, but little bit they are closely packed. So if there is little bit intramolecular interparticle distance are there, okay. This is what liquid, there is interparticle distance are larger compared to solid. Then here interparticle distance are larger, their interparticle distance are smallest, okay. In gas we will learn that they will be largest, okay. Here interparticle distance are larger, there is little bit more interparticle distance compared to solids. This is regarding compare, interparticle distance are larger compared to solids. Okay, so I hope you got this second point. Third point, almost incompressible. They are almost incompressible. You cannot compress liquid. Almost you can't compress a liquid very easily. So they are incompressible. Liquids are incompressible. You cannot compress the water. You cannot compress juice. Okay, they are incompressible. You cannot compress. Same thing, even in solid also, they are incompressible. Okay, these are almost incompressible. Okay, so you got the third point. Interparticle, second point, interparticle distances are larger, and the third point is they are almost incompressible. Okay, very difficult to compress them. 99% they, it is difficult to compress the liquids. Okay, fourth point, density is lower than solids and diffuse. See, density we have already spoke. What is density? Density is nothing but mass by volume. The density is lower than solids. The density in the case of solids, we understood that the density of solids is more. But here, the density is lower. In the case of solids, it is more. In the case of liquids, it is less. It is less. Okay, so density is lower here compared to solids. So here the solids are having more density, whereas liquids are having lower density than solids, and they diffuse. Solids and they also diffuse. In the diffusion process, solids are having less diffusion. Okay, solids usually do not diffuse very easily, but liquids can diffuse. Diffuse in the sense going moving from one form of matter to other form of matter. Okay, that means diffusion. Just I will give you an example. Perfume smells can be, perfume, liquid perfume can be diffused into the air. Okay, these dust particles, whatever present, they can be diffused into the air. Okay, so this is regarding diffusion. So next point, interparticle force of attraction is weaker than solids. See, interparticle force of attraction is weaker than solids. See, here in solids there is interparticle force of attraction is more. Here little bit weaker compared to solids. Why? Why? Because there is no much distance between them. They are highly closely packed, hence there will be large force of attraction. But here there is a larger distance compared to solids. Hence there will be a force of attraction less. There will be less force of attraction compared to solids. I hope you are getting my point. So last one, constituent particles are less closely packed. So all the constituent particles are less closely packed. Here highly closely packed, there in the liquids less closely packed. Means you can see there they are less closely packed. Since they are less closely packed, the force of attraction between the particles is less compared to solids. Hence the distance between them is also larger, and they can diffuse. Okay, these are the properties of liquids. Okay, see, just let us go once again through all these properties. So it is not having any fixed shape, but it is having fixed value. Interparticle distance are larger. Okay, just by looking at figure you can tell. So what you can see here, water, we have to imagine water is usually not having any fixed shape, but it is having fixed value. So liquids are not having fixed shape but fixed value. So interparticle distance are here larger. Then the force of attraction between the particles is less compared to solids. The constituent particles are less closely packed. So by looking that we can see about this, and these are almost incompressible, and the density is lower than the solids, and they diffuse very easily we can say. So these are the some points regarding properties of liquids. I hope everything is clear. And one question they might ask you here: density is lower than solids and diffuses there. But sometimes what happens, even though ice is a solid, ice floats on water. Why? The question will come. Why? Why? Because there are, even though ice is solid, but its density is way less compared to water. It happens only in this case of ice. Density of ice is very, very less compared to water. 90% of the liquids are having less density compared to solids. But in some conditions like ice, it is a different thing, that ice is having very less density compared to water. Hence, ice floats on water. Okay. Next, these are the points you have to remember. Please note down these points and understand this. Okay, on this basis, we will move to the next one. Okay. Those are properties of gas. What are the properties of gas we have to understand? So I hope solids clear, liquids clear, and now I have to go for the properties of gas. Okay. So we'll learn one by one. First property, second property, third property, we'll learn that. See, first property. What is my first property? See, gases are, they have fixed shape nor fixed value. Neither shape nor fixed value. Or definitely can say. It neither fixed shape nor fixed value. Okay. See, gases are having neither fixed shape nor fixed value. They are neither having any fixed shape nor fixed value. Means what? Gases will not be having any definite value. Gases are, even though they are kept in, they occupy the space in container, they can't be seen. They cannot have any proper shape. Okay, suppose if you take a balloon, in that balloon, what you are doing? You are putting some air through your mouth. So that air takes the shape of the balloon. So there is no fixed shape. Similar thing we can apply for volleyball. In the volleyball, air is blown, but that time air is taking what? Round shape. Okay, sphere shape. So that means air is not having any fixed shape. Again, there is no fixed value for air. Okay, we cannot say that it is having fixed value. So it is neither having fixed shape nor having fixed value. So both are not there. In solid, it is having both fixed shape, fixed value. In liquid, it is having fixed shape but not fixed value. Sorry, it is having fixed value but not fixed shape. When it comes to gas, it is neither having fixed shape nor having fixed value. Second point. What is my second point? Here we can say interparticle distance are largest. Interparticle distance are largest. Interparticle distance are largest. Okay. Here interparticle distance are largest. If I draw the gas If I draw the gas molecule structure, okay, see here the interparticle distance are more. The interparticle distance are more here. So the interparticle distance are largest, we can say. Since the interparticle distance are largest, what we can say again? They are less closely packed. They are less closely packed, and the force of attraction between the particles is very much small. We can say like that. Okay. Third one is, it is compressible. It is compressible. Gas can be compressed. Okay. We can compress the gas. Gas is compressible, whereas liquid is incompressible, almost incompressible. Solid is incompressible, completely incompressible. Liquid is almost incompressible, whereas gas is compressible. So this is, gas is compressible. So you got my point. Gas can be compressed. Okay, it can be compressed. Fourth point, density is low, way lower. Okay, density is lower than liquids and solids. Both liquids and solids density is very less, lower than liquids and solids. Compared to what we can say, compared to liquids and solids, density of gas is very much low. Why? Because it occupies maximum space. Okay, when anything occupies maximum space with less mass, its density will be less. Okay, so if the mass is more and occupying more space, that is density is more. If the mass is more, we can say density is more. But here it is occupying more volume but less mass, hence density is very very low compared to liquids and solids. And the fifth point is, as already told, diffusion also, we can say that here diffusion it happens, it also easily diffuses. Okay, gases also easily diffuses. Okay, gases is very easy to diffuse. Okay, whereas liquids are, they can be diffused. Solids are not easy to diffuse. Liquids, gases can be easily diffused. Sixth one, that we have already discussed this, interparticle force of attraction. What we can say, or let me rub somewhere because we don't have space there. Interparticle force of attraction. Okay, I will rub only the first one. Remember this. Okay. Fifth one, it is diffuses. Sixth one, interparticle force of attraction. Interparticle force of attraction is very very less. Interparticle force of attraction is very less compared to solid and liquid. So I will draw the diagram of liquid. So yes, this let it be liquid. This is liquid, gas is there. Okay, interparticle force of attraction is very less. So you can see that interparticle force of attraction, why it is very less? Because there is a largest distance between the particles. When there is largest distance, there will be less attraction. When there is a moderate distance, there will be moderate attraction. When there is very small distance, then there will be larger attraction. In solids, what happens? the interparticle attraction is small. Sorry, interparticle distance is small. Hence, interparticle attraction is very much more. Here in this case, it is moderate distance. They are maintaining moderate distance. Hence, interparticle attraction is moderate. Or you can say, interparticle attraction is less compared to solids. Here the interparticle attraction is very very less compared to liquids and solids, because the distance is more, distance between the particles are more, that we can say interparticle distance is more. Hence the interparticle attraction is very very less. Last one, the constituent particles are free to move. Constituent particles are free to move. Constituent particles are free to move. What it means? They are very, 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 very lessly closely packed. Okay? In solids, they are very much high closely packed. Very much closely packed, we can say. In liquids, they are less closely packed. But it, when it comes to gas, so you can see that they are free to move. Means they are not at all closely packed. You can say that too much less closely packed. Okay. So these are the properties of gases. These are the properties of liquids. So first one is there. No fixed shape but fixed value. So I just rub it. No fixed shape but fixed value. Okay. So this is first one, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. So those are also, there are 7 points. Okay. So these you have to remember. You have to understand these points and you have, you can compare them. On one chart, you write down, note down these points and those points also. Last class we have discussed solids, those points also you note down, and in one book you take the maximum space. Better if you take it in the horizontal way rather than vertical way. Take it in horizontal way and write down all these points. Okay, solids, liquids and gas, in only one book you can maintain that. Okay, so what you can write, so regarding shape you can write, regarding volume you can write. So you can make 6 to 7 points by comparing all those things. In solids, both it is having fixed shape, fixed volume, it is having no fixed shape but fixed volume. Liquid, gas is neither having any fixed shape nor fixed volume. So second point, what you can make, interparticle distance is less in solid. It is larger in liquid and it is the largest in gas. Third point you can make, solid is incompressible, liquid is almost incompressible, whereas gas is compressible. Fourth point, density is high in solids. Okay, in liquid density is lower than solids and density is very very low in gas. Fifth point, you can make diffusion. Solids cannot diffuse easily. Liquids can diffuse. Gases diffuses very easily. So you can make the diffusion as a fifth point. Here we have made diffusion as a fifth point. But in the case of solid and liquid, we have added in the fourth point only. So that is why solids and liquid, because in liquid it have become 6 points and gas they have become 7 points. So next point we can make, interparticle force of attraction is high in solids. Interparticle force of attraction is moderate in liquids or weaker than solids, we can say. Interparticle force of attraction is very very less in the case of gas. And last point, constituent particles are high, very closely packed in the case of solids. Next, in liquid, constituent particles are less closely packed. In gas, what we can say, constituent particles are free to move. So, we have to do all these things. Okay, we have to understand these concepts. So these are the properties of solids, liquids and gas. What is matter and properties of particles of matter, you have to remember. Types of matter, solids, liquid, gas, and properties of solids, liquids and gas. You can write all these in one page also. Okay, so remaining things we'll learn in the next class.